Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers. Welcome to a sensational cricket happening show today with your host Ram. This on a Saturday, as this sensational match happened at the United States of America in Lauderhill in Florida. As I said, the excitement would have been pretty electric, but what really turned out was electric entertainment at Lauderhill in Florida. And the reason it was electric entertainment was because of the fact the highest aggregate in a T20 match. What a source of entertainment for all the spectators at the United States in Lauderhill in Florida. They have really come in droves today, as one would have expected, as a mountain of runs was scored, as in this particular match got the highest aggregate of aggregate in a T20 match, as 489 runs were scored by both the sides. And finally, it was West Indies who were the victors by just a single run of the last ball of the final over. As I said, this there were 489 runs who cascaded from the blade of the batsman, and even that, in fact, it broke all the records. I mean, even if you go into the IPL, the previous best was 469, and now the record for the highest aggregate is 489, and that happened in the United States, Lauderhill in Florida. And what else, what more can one expect from this particular match here? And also, the number of sixes in the match also broke the record, as 32 sixes were hit high in the sky by the Indians and the West Indies, especially West Indies setting another record, as they went on to actually break a particular record which was there, and they had 21 sixes, and this is the most by in fact, they didn't break it, they actually equaled the record which was set in an IPL game between Royal Challengers Bangalore, who hit 21 sixes. And today it was the West Indies actually equaled that, as 21 sixes were scotched by the West Indies, with 11 coming from India's bat. And the other thing was that there was also there was the threat of the fastest century, as you know, in T20 cricket, still stands in the name of Richard Levy of South Africa, when he scotched it against the New Zealand, against the Kiwis, when he actually hit a century of 45 balls, and that record still stands. And today it was almost on the verge of actually the breaking that record, but that didn't happen, as Evan Lewis, who came into the West Indian team as a real surprise packet, I would say, as he replaced Chris Gayle, who couldn't play today, as he scored a century of just 48 balls. He was the one who actually picked up the Man of the Match award, and KL Rahul of India was not far behind with a 46 ball century, but even that was not enough to actually get the Indians victory. But as I said, what a match it was, and you also saw Stuart Binney being carted for 32 runs of a single over when Lewis struck 5 sixes in one single over of Stuart Binney. And as I said, it was absolute mayhem at Lauderhill in Florida today, with runs just cascading at the rate of a flow of water, I would say. And as I said, I'm going to start off with this. So basically, this is the first thing that I wanted to talk about, and now we are getting on to the brass tacks, I would say, as to what exactly happened there at Lauderhill in Florida. So let's have a look at the card here. As I said, it was simply breathtaking stuff. And finally, one thing that I would say here is that the West Indies making 245 for 6 of 20 overs batting first, and India finishing just one run short. And let's talk about the last over, which was bowled by Dwayne Bravo, an absolute champion stuff bowling from Dwayne Bravo, mixing it up with the slower ball, his Yorker. And look at it, in the final ball, India needed just 2 runs, 1 to equal this, equal the West Indian score, and one to actually go past them to win it, or it could be a super over. But neither that happened, as India, the last delivery which Bravo bowled Dhoni would have been definitely expected to give India the victory, but at the last ball of the over, Dhoni actually gave a catch to short third man. Very well thought out ball from Dwayne Bravo, and I would say Dwayne Bravo should be commended a great deal on a really, really absolute belter of a pitch, Dwayne Bravo bowling the final over to with Mahendra Singh Dhoni and KL Rahul. KL Rahul absolutely well set at the crease, and Mahendra Singh Dhoni, I think Dwayne Bravo almost pulled a sort of a real rabbit out of a hat here, because by getting the West Indies to victory, but just one run in the final, as I said, it was champion bowling, champion stuff coming in from Dwayne Bravo. What a delivery. I mean, Dwayne Bravo was caught. I mean, Dhoni was caught at short third man. And that was it. The West Indies were victors by one run. And Carlos Brathwaite, being the captain, captaining the West Indies for the first time on his debut, actually got a victory of the very fine. And what a sort of introduction for Carlos Brathwaite as captain. A sensational match happening. So now, as I said, I just wanted to take you down to the excitement, and now let's talk about this game. So West Indies batting first, and let's also talk about Johnson Charles. He scotched a 20-ball 50 first up. So as I said, the Central Broward Regional Park Stadium, turf ground, Lauderhill, United States, was absolutely chock-a-block. People have come in droves, and there was no doubt about it, and they got electric entertainment here at Lauderhill in Florida with Johnson Charles and even Lewis starting. Even Lewis, I mean, one would have been a bit really disappointed to see Chris Gayle not being there in the team, and as for India, Shikhar Dhawan was not there, and Lowell, and both the batsmen who actually replaced in their respective teams really gave a sort of the run for their money as far as the Lauderhill crowd in Florida were concerned, as Johnson Charles started it off by scorching off a 50 of just 20 deliveries. He absolutely pummeled the Indian bowlers. Mohammad Shami, as I said, there was nothing in it for the bowlers. It was an absolute belter of a track, and West Indies belted the Indian innings to the tune of 245 for 6 of their 20 overs. Johnson hitting a scorching 50 of 20 balls and finally ending up with 79 of just 33 deliveries, 6 fours and 7 sixes carton. And the partnership was 126 in 10 overs. At the other end, even Lewis was absolutely smashing it all across the park, and he manhandled Stuart Binney by clouting him for 32 runs in a single over, inclusive of 5 sixes. And even Lewis getting on to essentially a 48 deliveries, what a knock. I mean, replacing Chris Gayle and really playing a real blinder there. Andre Russell making 22 of 12 balls, 1 4 and 2 sixes. Pollard 22 of 15 with 2 sixes. Brathwaite 14 of 10 with 1 4 and 1 sixes. Bravo's not out on 1. Simmons bowled. Boomer Fanat 245 for 6. The Indian bowlers wilted under the belt, under the blade of the West Indian batsmen. Mohammad Shami, 4 overs, carted for 48 runs on 1 wicket. Bhuvneshwar Kumar disappearing for 43 runs of his 4 wickets, 4 overs with none to his name. Bumrah, 2 for 47 of 4. Ashwin, 4 overs, clattered for 36. Jadeja, 3 overs, really absolutely smashed for 39 runs with 2 wickets. And Stuart Binney was totally demoralized by Evan Lewis, 32 runs, and he never bowled again. India chasing that, didn't have a good start, I would say. Ajinkya Rahane going for the ram shot, was caught by Bravo, the bowling of Russell for 7 of as many balls, 1-4. Virat Kohli disappointed after making 16 of 9 deliveries, 3-4s. And now it was Rohit Sharma and Rahul at the crease, and Rohit Sharma was really getting it. Rohit Sharma and Rahul made sure that they are not going to leave this opportunity, and they are going to really take it to the West Indian bowlers. And they were not bothered. They had only one way to play, and that was to play aggressive, as Rohit Sharma started hitting runs pretty quickly. At the other end, KL Rahul was not far behind. He was also really putting the ball into the boundary and over the boundary, and as finally the runs really started coming in with Rohit Sharma and KL Rahul really punishing. And but as the score reached 137, they lost Rohit Sharma for 62 of 28 deliveries, 4 fours and 4 sixes. And after that, I mean, Sunil Narine came in for some severe tap from the Indian batsman today. His 3 overs were absolutely dismissed for 50 runs. And then KL Rahul lost Rohit Sharma, and after that, from 137 for 3, Mahendra Singh Dhoni came into the crease. But KL Rahul, once Dhoni came in, we saw KL Rahul absolutely turn it on, and he started getting runs absolutely quickly. as runs kept on coming, and India started moving closer to the West Indian target as that was happening. And then finally KL Rahul got a century. He got a century of 46 balls. Is that Richard Levy's record for the fastest T20 in the history of T20 matches, as he scored against New Zealand of 45 balls, still remains the record. But this record was absolutely under threat today, as KL Rahul played a master innings of 110, and finally the match coming down to the absolute wire here at Lauderhill in Florida, with 7 runs being defended by Bravo defending 7 runs. And that 7 runs, what a superb bowling. As I said, champion bowling from Dwayne Bravo, keeping KL Rahul and Dhoni quiet, not allowing them to really get any boundaries. And then finally it all came down to the final delivery, and Dwayne Bravo definitely knows what Dhoni can do, as he has already played with him in the Chennai Super Kings in the IPL. So he sensed that. He also said that in the post-match interview, that he knew what Dhoni was going to do. He was going to be on the safer side, and Dhoni was the one who actually, and what a coincidence, Marlon Samuels dropping the catch of Bravo, the first ball when Dhoni played, and then in the final ball, Samuels picks up the catch to bring the win for the West Indies. And Dhoni was gone for 43 of 25 balls, which left KL Rahul not out on 110 of 51 balls, 12 fours and 5 sixes. And this is the fastest century by an Indian batsman in T20 cricket. So KL Rahul holding the record now. Looking at the bowling figures, you see what damage they did. 4 overs for 53 for Andre Russell. Badri 2 overs 25. Bravo 2 for 37. Hats off to Dwayne Bravo for bowling the 7th over in absolutely a champion style there. He definitely is a champion. Sunil Narain, as I said, 3 overs dismissed for 50. Brathwaite 4 overs 47. Polat 3 overs, I thought he bowled with a semblance of respectability, 1 for 30. As West Indies lead the 2-match series 1-0, even Lewis from West Indies was named man of the match. But what a source of electric entertainment for the crowd here at Lauderhill in Florida. And United States saw some great biffing going on between the both teams, and tomorrow there's one more game, and I am sure that should be a cracker. And probably we are going to get I'm sure the crowd is going to really, really fill up the stadium once again, because they know what to expect on this belter of a wicket here in Lauderhill in Florida. And this is something that was absolutely sensational stuff here at Lauderhill in Florida. And I'm sure the United States cricket fans would have absolutely had a real ball here at the Lauderhill in Florida today. So let's, as I said, now I'm going to just skim off for the other matches. Let's give me a summary here of the match between England and Pakistan, which was the England actually going on to a 2-0 lead, as Pakistan batting first made 251. They were in all sorts of trouble. In fact, one was wondering as to why Pakistan, after winning the toss, elected to actually bat on a green tin surface, as they were reduced to 2 for 3, and Sami Aslam was the first to go. He was caught down the leg side of the bowling of Wokes, and Mark Wood, what a delivery from Mark Wood. Delivery of the day, I would say, starting on the leg stump and coming in and knocking Shahjil Khan's off stump for naught. And Azhar Ali was nipped in by a delivery from Wokes, which nipped away and bounced in. A Butler behind the cat, stump staying the catch. He was gone to the bowling of Wokes for naught, and Pakistan were in dire trouble at 2 for 3. And then we saw Sarfraz Ahmed come in and play a good hand, as he got to his second one day international century, and he had to curb his natural instinct, but he did it well by scoring 105, 130 deliveries with 6 fours, getting some support from Babar Azam, 30 of 33 deliveries, 5 fours, Shoaib Malik making 28 of 35, 1 4, but Imad Wazim was very impressive, taking Pakistan to 251 all out, as he contributed an unbeaten 63 of 70 deliveries, 5 fours and 1 6, 251 all out. And as far as England were concerned, for England it was not so easy. They lost Jason Roy pretty early in the piece, bowled by Mohammad Amir. Alex Shields was out to a sweep shot of the bowling of spinner Imad Wazim. After that, contributions coming in from Joe Root from 89 of 108 balls with 5 fours. Morgan making 68, not a very convincing 68, I would say, of Eddie Dunne's 9-4. Nonetheless, he got it, got him into some form. Ben Stokes looking pretty lively with 42 of 30, Dunne's 6-4s and 1-6. And in the end, it was Moylan and Wokes actually taking them to victory as they won the match by England winning the match by 4 wickets here at the Lord's Cricket Ground to take a 2-0 lead in the one-day series against Pakistan, and England leading the 5-match series. Joe Root was named man of the match. As far as the Test match was concerned, in the second day's play between South Africa and New Zealand, the South Africans really made hay, I would say. Even though this pitch, I would say, it was very sunny. There was no cloud cover. I thought that there was a sort of a greenish tinge on the pitch. And New Zealand, after winning the toss, inserted the South Africans into bat. And the South Africans they did very well. If you look at it, it was Cook making 56. In fact, I thought the New Zealand bowlers really well bowled well, even though there was not much cloud cover, and they swung the ball well. They really beat the bat. It was Cook and Quinton de Kock actually opening for the first time in a test match. Both really knuckled down together to knock 133, with Cook making 56 with 9 boundaries, Quinton de Kock making 82 with 15 boundaries, Hashim Amla making a sweet 58. With 9-4s and 1-6. Dumini getting into some real form here with an unbeaten 67 to his name with 10 boundaries. Du Plessis was not on 13 at stumps. As stumps on day one, South Africa taking the honours, making 283 for 3. 2 wickets to Neil Wagner, 1 to Doug Bracewell. So that's a match situation. As I said today, I had to really skim off because of the sensational T20 match that happened between India and the West Indies, Lauderhill in Florida. If at all you need to know more about all these three matches, if at all you still need to see my comments, come on, go and join me as Twitter followers. I'll be there on Twitter tweeting about all these three matches in greater detail. Hope to catch up with you all there on Twitter. Until I see you tomorrow, dear folks, on my cricket broadcast, that's on a Sunday. This is your host, Ram, signing off for the day. Thank you.